I'm Dr. Suresh, professor in Electronics and Communication Engineering Department of Fisher Engineering College. So we are working on the embedded systems project, which we are mainly focusing on surveillance of LOC, thermal gel applications.
I would like to extend my sincere thanks to Texas Instruments for conducting such an excellent project contest to motivate the students to work in the engineering field.
As far as India is concerned, the major security threat which challenges the Indian military is infiltration of antisocial elements through certain regions along the line of control, where severe monitoring is difficult because of negative temperature and highly dense forests. This project aims at developing an embedded-based solution for surveillance and monitoring along the line of control by deploying multiple autonomous drones.
Bahut difficult ho jata hai, barf bahut hai.
Because of the terrain, it becomes very difficult to move around. The snow is waist deep. Though it is very difficult to walk around, these hardships are nothing new to us. We have done it before and we can overcome them now as well.
Hi all, I am Ganesh,
this
is Nagarjuna, and my another team member is this, name is Padmanabhan, and we are from Isho Engineering College, and our mentor is Dr. G.R. Suresh, and our project title is about an extensive monitoring and surveillance along LOC using multiple autonomous drones. And we are going to explain the components like this.
This is BeagleBone SBC from Texas. It's a launch pad 0000. It's used for communication. Propellers, 11-inch propeller for the quadcopter.
This is a power distribution board.
4 ESCs. This is the electronic speed controller to control the BLDC motor.
And these are the wires, male to male, male to female. And the AC is connected to the BLDC motor, like this. And the BLDC motor, it is a 980 kV, 10 amp BLDC motor. And for the assembling part, these propellers are connected to the BLDC motor. And these are the overall assembly of the quadcopter. To stabilize the quadcopter, we need a gyroscope to maintain the angles. So as you are going to see, this is a gyroscope MPU6050. In that, there is a VCC pin, ground pin, SD and SCL pin. So we are going to connect the gyro to our BeagleBone Black using I2C communication. So in BeagleBone Black, P9 header, 19 and 20 pin are the serial clock and serial data lines. So we are connecting the SD and SL line to the 19th and 20th pin, and the VCC pin to the 3.3 volt, and the ground to the BeagleBone ground. So now we are going to see the, we are going to run the code. When I change the angle of the gyro, the reading changes from positive to negative. When I go for the positive x direction, it will be showing in positive. When I go for the negative, rotate in other side, it shows a negative reading. Using this, we are going to stabilize the quadcopter. In an ADAPT network, we are going to use the TA part. It's a C3200 launch pad. So we are going to configure the launch pad to create an ADAPT network. For that, we are using the Energia IDE. Energia IDE. So in that, you can see as a Wi-Fi name, I will set as a launch pad. For the password, I set as a 1234567 8. So I am going to program the launch pad. It's compiling stage, it's uploading. Take some time. Done uploading. Now, as you see on your laptop, there's a network. So you can see there's a network here, launchpad. So I'm going to just connect to this network. It's ask for security key 1234567 8. And connected to this network. So we are going to connect our BeagleBone Black to this network. So I have connected a USB dongle to the USB port in the vehicle bone black. So it will be act as a Wi-Fi dongle, Wi-Fi communications. Okay. In vehicle bone black, we are going to see WACD cursors. It's a, as you can see, the launchpad network is showing here. We are going to connect to that network. So it's shift plus C to connect. As you can see, this launchpad is putting interface up. So it's obtaining IP address.
A single BLDC motor control using BeagleBone Black. We are going to control the speed of the BLDC motor using the PWM pin in the BeagleBone Black.
Motor is connected to the electronic speed controller ESC to the three leads, and for the control there are two pins, one for the trigger and one for the ground. So like this. So you see here the red pin is the trigger, it's connected to the 13th pin of the P8 header, and the black pin is the ground, is connected to the BeagleBone Black ground switch. Now I run the code. This is a Python language, so we are going to use a Python code. So as you can see, it's initialization. So I'm going to give the duty cycle as 50, so it will be running at a 50 duty cycle. So I vary the speed like 80. So you can see the variation in the speed. So I'm going to do 10 now. As you can see, the motor speed is controlled using the duty cycle. So now I'm going to give the 0. It's going to stop.
Here we are going to show the quadcopter testing. Here we are going to identify the quadcopter without causing the error value to the IMU and also to BeagleBone. So it won't take off. We are giving it some delay. After this delay starts again, as you are seeing, the delay value, once the delay is processed, it will start. This is another case of the testing. Here we are causing the PED error value in IMU using the gyroscope for testing purpose. And again also we are giving some delay. For those delay, it stops rotating. Yeah, it's fine. Again we are going to pass the PED error correctly. Here it starts to take off, it starts in its phase to take off, but due to the increase in the speed of the motor, it won't take off that much completely.
This is quadcopter with the camera testing without the propellers, without initializing the quadcopter. We are showing how the quadcopter shows the camera view in different angles. We are displaying with the camera, and also we are connecting the camera through wireless medium, and it's connected to the TV, and here it shows. And this is while working, here we are going to explain the wireless communication between the ground robot and the quadcopter. This is ground robot, it rotates with the BeagleBone. The BeagleBone is placed on the top of the here. Once the quadcopter is rotating, the ground robot moves accordingly. The quadcopter extends this information. This is the coordination between the multiple ground robots. Once the ground one robot takes the right turn or left turn, similarly the another robot also gets take place the right turn or left turn accordingly.
Create a network. In network, the ground robot connected to a Wi-Fi dongle.
Yeah, I would like to thank the Texas Instruments and Ishiri Engineering College for supporting our valuable projects. Thank you, Anadar.